Take my treasure and fulfill the dream I never could.
To boot. But hang on, is that all it is? That scraggy old bit of paper? That's pathetic. If I'd have known it was as naff as that, I'd never have bothered. I suppose I'll just have to make do with the 10,000 gold coins I picked up on the way.
Here. Did you score all that dosh in this cave? Blimey, you're a crafty devil, aren't you? We got what we came for anyhow. Meaning, there ain't no point hanging round here anymore. Let's hop it, eh?
Wait up.
Oh,
I'll come with you.
You?
You know me. I've got a nose for treasure. And I reckon you lot stink of it.
Leave it out, Red. We ain't messing around here, all right? This is serious business.
I don't remember asking for permission. My mind's made up, so you can like it or lump it.
Oh, suit yourself. I was only trying to be considerate.
But I think it's a splendid idea. Cool. The girl wishes to join our illustrious band, does she not? Well, the more the merrier, I say. Safety in numbers and so on.
Not fine. Just don't say I didn't warn you.
Let's settle then. I'll tag along with you lot for a bit.
Well, it would seem I've accumulated a somewhat larger entourage since we left. Henceforth, I think it would be prudent if one or the other of you remain behind to guard Medea and I whenever the rest of the party leaves the wagon. Yes, I know what you're thinking, but one will be quite sufficient. And I dare say it will stop you tripping over each other in those cramped caves you like to frequent. Naturally, if whoever is on guard duty is carrying an important item, I'll see that it gets transferred to the bag before the rest of you set off.
All right, I'll see you lot on the boat then.